So we won the roll. I think our deck can afford to draw. We have a lot of cards like Wall of Tanglecord and Perilous Mirror that should allow us to be okay on the draw. We shouldn't have a problem with getting overrun. And if at all possible, I like to draw in this draft format since games tend to go long, and being up a card is worth the cost. Our hand isn't the greatest, but I kind of want to keep it. It has lands and spells, and it has three mounds, which is a perfect number. And I feel like because of the way our deck's structured, just having lands and spells should lead to a fair amount of success. Draw Supper should be able to trade with something, and then Wall of Tanglecord obviously is good at buying time. And I'm hoping between those two, we should get to our late game, which should be better than almost any opponent's. Ironically, the one thing I don't like about our deck is that it lacks removal, and it's pretty odd for a red-black deck to have that problem, but I think our deck does. I really would have wished I had picked up a little more. I guess part of the reason I didn't was because I didn't know I was in black. It is one of the problems with using this very open strategy. So, Horizon Spellbomb will be getting a forest probably since we're good on swamps and mountains, and it'll allow us to make our Wall of Tanglecord fly. I'd like to hold off as long as possible on Horizon Spellbomb so that we can try to draw a card off of it, but we're only on a one outer for that, so I'm not gonna wait forever. Now I'm just gonna get a bunch of stuff on the board. Now, awkwardly, if he equips Copper Carapace to Chrome Steed, we can't block it with Wall of Tanglecord effectively. And since it looks like that means we're going to be in the controlling role, I'm going to not attack with Necrogen Scudder and just keep it up to block his Glenhawk Idol in case. It's a little awkward, but I think it's worth it since we're about to take six here, and taking six is at least a little better than taking eight. So if he decided to not equip, he probably has Arc Trail or something like that, but I am certainly going to bite. Wow, okay, I did not expect that. Yeah, nothing we can do. So I'm gonna try to cantrip out the Panic Spellbomb on the Chrome Steed to see what I can find. So a Rusted Slasher will at least hold down the fort reasonably well. One, if he equips Carapace and attacks, one option is I could block and sack Horizon Spellbomb to regenerate it, since I won't need the land. So, I mean, I'm probably going to lose a pretty significant number of the games where I don't draw any bombs. So, fingers crossed that I can find something soon here. And that's going to be pretty good. He can Bard Battlegear up his Glenhawk Idol. Hopefully he swings with the Chrome Steed, since I will snap block regen. Nope. So we are going to have to find an answer to that Chrome Steed. And fast. Our deck isn't the best against flyers. If we get a green source, then Wall of Tanglecord can shut them down a little bit. but we don't really have a whole lot of answers. Obviously, at the higher end, we have flyers of our own, like Kuldotha Phoenix. So I think this is actually a mistake on his part. If he just suits up the Glenhawk Idol with Bard Battle Gear, I think he's much better off. As it is, I'm going to be able to buy a little bit of time. Although, if I don't draw anything, he's representing lethal next turn anyway. And that'll do it. So, we just lost because, as I said, our deck is underpowered if we don't draw any of our Balmy cards. I don't really have a sideboarding plan for him. I think I like the way our deck is configured. Yeah, I think I'm just going to leave it as is. I don't really see any reason to change.